is this even legal? Is the topic we're going to talk about today. As you have seen the image of Elon Musk, is this AI generated or is this a real image? In this video, I will show you how you can use Midjourney to generate every image you want to, but this will be much more advanced. So I will show you how to actually take your face and put it on every character, and how you can also use the characters of well-known people and actually generate whatever you want to generate. And this is a very fine line, as you will understand, a very fine line of what is still real and what is not real anymore. So stay tuned. And in this video, I'm going to show you all the details and the advanced things and the things that make it much easier for you to apply this new face swapping technique that Midjourney rolled out some months ago to your pictures and to your life, because this makes your life, or can make your life, a lot easier. If you want to generate some thumbnails for yourself, or if you just want to have some fun, share something on social media, or use it for different purposes, this is the perfect video for you to understand how you can do it fast and easy. Let's now head over to Midjourney and have a look how we can do the magic. So if you don't already have Midjourney installed, you need to actually create a server here. I've shown that in one of my other videos, so please have a look. Just to explain it in very short details, you need to just make a private server here, upload a picture you want, then just create it. Then you need to invite the Midjourney bot. I've also done a video about that. And you need to invite the inside face swap bot. And what you can do then is you can either generate images. So for example, I've generated this image here of Elon Musk, as you can see. So it's the usual way, just go ahead and type imagine, then your image prompt. And this is of course something that is not new to you. So this is generating the image of Elon Musk, which is actually pretty good. So Midjourney is getting really good at producing stuff, especially from well-known people, and it's generating the images. But what I want to show you is how you can actually use your face and put your face on everybody else, or take Elon Musk's face, or take the president's face, or whatever you want to do. Take the face and put it on every generated image or on every stock image, because this is also a good trick I will show you. You can go ahead here and switch and look for royalty-free images. You can use whatever website you want to use. So let's have a look what we can use. Let's just use this image. I hope it's not too dark, and we'll just download it here. I think it started to download. Here we will just, the quality is not that interesting or not that critical. I will just download it to my download folder. Then I will switch to Discord again and I will upload it. But before I do that, I will actually put in my face into the bot. So the inside face swap bot has to be installed as well. It's very easy to do. Just watch the other tutorials I made to be able to do that. But then you can go ahead here and type in slash, and you will be able to access this. And here there's an option, save identity feature by name and image. So I'm going to use this picture and I will just upload it, but then I have to also give it a name. So I will just use my name and upload it. And from this time on, the bot will actually have my face and the identity binds to it. So what we can do now is, for example, we could upscale this image here from Elon Musk. This will be upscaled in a second. So now it's upscaled, and what I can do now is I go to these three dots here and say app in swapper. And it will actually take the last face that I uploaded, and you see it is now using my face for it. But what you can also do is you can take this stock image that we downloaded already, and I will just upload the stock image. I'll
just click on the plus, upload any file you want to upload. I think we put it in the downloads. So we'll use this guy with the popcorn, upload it. Just make sure it's uploaded. And then we click here again on the apps in swap, and you will see my face will be on this in a second. You see? You notice the hair is always stays the same. On, of course, also the body stays the same. I made some experiences or some tests, and you can even go ahead here and apply it again. So I did this 3 or 4 times, and then I noticed it looks even more like me. You see, this even looks more like me. Sometimes it's getting cartoony, but I do it again here. I apply it again. And most of the time, the second or the third image is actually the best one if I try it. This is already too much here. You see in the eyes, it's not perfect anymore. This one, I think, is still good. Let's check out the first one again. I would say the second one is the best one. So if I would like to make a thumbnail or something like this, I would just use this functionality with the face swapping. You can use any of these stock images, any image you find wherever on the web, like this guy or some other scene, and combine it. So you don't even have to generate your own images. You can generate your own images, but you can also use stock images to create your perfect thumbnail. So I hope you learned a lot in this video and you know now how to swap your face and to put your face on any stock image or on any image that you generate with Midjourney. Don't forget to subscribe, leave a like, and I see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.